Hello everyone, Robert Rambles here, and welcome back to our Blood Elf Hunter's Journey in Wrath of the Lich King Classic. Thank you guys very much for clicking on the video and joining me here today. I do appreciate it, and I hope you are all doing well. We are going to start off taking care of our green quest today. We're going to go after the remaining lynxes. We have to go to the Underlight Mine. And eventually, we'll work our way over to Windrunner Village and Windrunner Spire. And I will pop us into the queue early today. Perhaps we will actually be able to complete a full dungeon run. Looks like we are available for Wailing Caverns, Dead Mines, or even Shadowfang Keep at this point. Alright, with that one done, next let's head over to the Underlight Mine. Thank you.
enemies will fall.
Underlight ore samples. I was sent here from the Sanctum of the Sun to collect ore samples, but the gnolls have overrun the place. It's going to be my head on a platter if I don't get those samples to the Magister soon. Maybe you could help, Hunter.
Remember the sun well.
Alright, so we're killing gnolls, scavengers, and shaman, and we're looking for ore. Pretty sure they all have a chance to drop it. I realize at some point soon, I'm going to have to level up our bandages. We only have over 100 linen that we're not using. And it's starting to become an inventory problem all on its own.
Thank you.
All right, well, with these two done, we're going to head back to town and sort out our inventory issues. I think I'm going to have to bite the bullet and just, we can either mail off the linen, and I could do it later, or I could sit here and we can make about 100 bandages. Crafting moves a little bit faster in Wrath than it does in Vanilla Era, but I still think that I'll probably mail the linen off, and then I'll just return it later, and I'll take care of that stuff off recording. Because, yeah, I mean, having four inventory spots available is not really a good look right now.
What do you require? Trust no one.
All right, let's make some of the bandages so that we have some. But then we are going to send a bunch to the bank vaults. We'll try to make them until 50. At 50, I'm pretty sure we can craft the heavy linen. Alright, there we go. We'll mail the rest of the linen off. We're already getting wool cloth. That should be good. And then we can vendor and pick up some additional water.
Loiter. is of the essence.
We probably don't want to try to solo lose run yet. Maybe when we're a bit of a higher level with the pet we can. But right now I feel like it would be prudent to run away. I really would like a pet that can charge. Yeah, having the pet that has to run all the way in, that's not really getting aggro off of us. I'd really love a pet that can charge. I guess in that case I need to train a boar. Alright, looking like dead mines again. Let's see if maybe, maybe our healer will have mana. Maybe they'll be able to push heal buttons and maybe we won't run out of arrows. Well, we're in yet another run where the healer is letting the tank get abnormally low. Like, I don't really know what it is. I mean, to be fair, the tank keeps going and going and going and going and going. So that's, like, that's his bad. You know, he should probably slow down a little bit. But I wish the healers would heal the tanks. You know, press a couple of healing buttons. Could be really good. It's hard enough to find tanks as it is. There's no reason just to not heal them. If you have mana, heal the tank. Even if you think he's pulling a little fast, if you have mana, please heal the tank. That would be preferable. I mean, you could try to show them, like, teach them a lesson, but they're not going to learn a lesson. They're probably just going to stop tanking dungeons, which means less dungeons for everybody. And then they're still probably going to take the items. So, yeah. Now if he could res the tank, that'd be awesome. Yeah, there you go, buddy. Good job. He says, it helps if I have mana. But he had mana. We were looking the whole time. There was never a part in time in the boss fight from when it started, before it started, that he had less than half mana. If you have half your mana pool in Wrath of the Lich King, you can heal a 5-man dungeon boss fight. I promise you it's going to be okay. At least try to heal, and that way you can say you tried and it didn't work. When you stand there and do nothing, and then you say it helps if I have mana, that doesn't make me feel bad for you. It makes me feel like maybe you should have tried healing with the half bar of mana you had, and it probably would have been enough. Now I would say would be an okay time for the healer to have a little bit of mana back, but even with that being the case, like, they're over half, so I don't know. I feel like in Wrath of the Lich King, even if you have a quarter of a bar of mana, like, you can probably still heal through most pulls. Even if all you do is throw, like, a Power Word shield up, you know, especially as a priest. Power Word shield, renew, hope for the best, that'll get you through most pulls. I mean, if I were the tank, I probably would not have pulled the boss. That being said, again, he's just not really getting any heals, which is, it's kind of silly. Like, yeah, he's probably not a great tank, but you got half your mana. You could throw him a Power Word Shield. Just for the group, you know, don't do it for the tank. Do it for the group that you're in. We can vote to kick the tank if that's what has to happen, but don't stop healing the tank. Really, all I could think. If you really hate your tank and you're just not going to try to keep them alive, just vote to kick them. Vote to kick them. See if everybody agrees, and then move on with life. Because otherwise, it just makes it kind of more punishing for the rest of the group, in my opinion. Because I don't know. Like, yeah, the healer's oom now. Of course, they're oom now. They've had to keep everybody else alive. But they definitely weren't oom when the pull started. You know. Just, like, a little bit of effort. And I would say this to anybody thinking about healing. If you don't want to sometimes heal bad tanks, don't be a healer. You're going to, especially in LFD, you're going to come across tanks that want to pull really, really fast. You're going to come across tanks that don't care if you have less than half of your mana. You're going to come across tanks that don't care if you have a quarter of your mana. You have to decide if you actually want to be a healer and support the group, because sometimes that means putting up with a tank who's pulling too fast. And you could say something to them in party, but ultimately, like, standing back at half mana and letting the tank go down is not the way to do it. In all of that complaining somewhere, we did hit level 19. We'll take a look at our talents in a second. Now, this pull, probably outside of their ability to do much about it. They don't seem like a great healer, like, mana-wise, so there probably wasn't a lot that they can do for this pull. And see, now we no longer have a tank. That's basically just how it happens. I mean, I'm just kind of trying to continue to clear carefully in the hopes that we get a tank, because that is what we're waiting on right now. Do we take this group? Like, nah, I don't think so. Not with a mage. Maybe the mage could sheep one of them. Not really what I want. There we go. I realize that for whatever reason, there's been no music in here at all. Not really sure what's up with that. Might be worth having it if we get other parts of the set.
Check out that noise! We're under attack! Avast, you swabs! Repel the invaders! Making me angry!
Well, this is not great. Yeah, then again, maybe it's absolutely fine. That's a pretty nice step. It's lovely to see a healer who complained about not having mana earlier in the run be the last person to sit and drink before the last boss fight. That makes sense. Yeah, it's an upgrade, and it looks cool. An upgrade is an upgrade, however, it doesn't help when we don't have any room in our inventory. What are we gonna drop on the ground? Probably that. Boop. And that's it. We are out. All gear is hunter gear. That is what we know. Alright guys, that is the time that I have for today. It was an interesting run. We continued to get interesting tanks and interesting healers. I look forward to queuing up more in the future. I'm sure we'll get more entertainment. Thank you guys very much for being here. If you're digging the series, leaving a like on the video, subbing to the channel, ringing the bell, all of those things help me out immensely, and I appreciate those that do. Until next time, take care of yourselves out there in the real world, and take care of each other, and we'll see you back in Azeroth again very soon. Bye for now.